Did you know that before antibiotics were developed, doctors treated tuberculosis by sending patients to sanatoriums where they were exposed to sunlight? These doctors knew that something in the sunlight was killing tuberculosis and healing their patients. They also knew that consuming cod liver oil helped fight tuberculosis. So what does cod liver oil and exposure to sunlight have in common? Well, it's vitamin D. In fact, it has been known for a long time that vitamin D helps in the treatment of not just tuberculosis, but many other infectious diseases. Multiple cross-sectional studies have shown an association between low levels of vitamin D and increased viral and bacterial infection. I found this interesting study that was conducted on 19,000 people who had a vitamin D lower than 30 nanograms per milliliter. Subjects with low levels of vitamin D were more likely to self-report upper respiratory tract infection compared to folks with normal levels of vitamin D. Even after adjusting for variables like season, age, gender, body mass, and race, higher levels of vitamin D always correlated with a more robust immune system. This outcome was also backed by various other cross-sectional studies looking at a correlation between lower levels of vitamin D and higher rates of influenza, bacterial vaginosis, and even HIV infection. Now, some doctors have long suspected that vitamin D helps boost our immune system. But the first hint that vitamin D plays a significant role in boosting our immune system, that was made when scientists found the presence of the vitamin D receptors on our immune cells. This was a breakthrough discovery because till then, vitamin D was only assumed to promote calcium homeostasis and bone health. In simple English, this discovery proved that vitamin D plays a vital role in boosting our immune system and helping it fight various bacterial and viral infections. By the way, if you are finding this content useful, please like this video and subscribe to TechnoPanda Life so that you don't miss out any of my future videos. Now let's take a look at this peer-reviewed research paper, which is available at the US National Library of Medicine. Here, the authors conclude that vitamin D serves an important function beyond calcium and bone homeostasis. Vitamin D helps with the modulation of our innate and adaptive immune response. The cells in our immune system are capable of synthesizing and responding to vitamin D. The authors also highlight the fact that patients suffering from autoimmune diseases, so stuff like multiple sclerosis, arthritis, diabetes, inflammatory bowel disease, and lupus, they usually tend to be deficient in vitamin D. But the good news is that the immune cell in autoimmune diseases are responsive to the healing effects of vitamin D. So here is the bottom line. Vitamin D is an amazing vitamin that not only strengthens your bones and teeth, but also boosts your immune system and fights various autoimmune diseases. So with this mountain of data showing the benefits of vitamin D, it's imperative that everyone get adequate levels of vitamin D. Your immune system is the last line of defense, and it makes sense to give it all the help that it needs. Personally, I have suffered from vitamin D deficiency in the past, and only after taking 5,000 IUs of vitamin D3 supplement daily, I was able to raise my vitamin D levels to a healthy, serum level of around 50 nanograms per milliliter. Now, if you're not sure about your vitamin D levels, I would recommend that you ask your doctor to give you a vitamin D test. It's a simple blood test that will accurately tell you if you are deficient in vitamin D. And if you are deficient, then vitamin D3 supplements are the quick and easy way to raise your levels to a healthy range. Unfortunately, the NIH daily recommended dietary guidelines for vitamin D, it's fairly outdated and it definitely needs an update. So watch this video over here where I specifically talk about the adequate vitamin D3 supplement dose that healthy adults need. In this video, I also talk about the benefits of combining vitamin D3 with vitamin K2. So definitely check out this video and I will see you guys over there. Bye.